Now we can move to basic image processing task. Why do we need to process images? There are several reasons for this. First is image improvement for human perception, to make the image better looking, to improve the subjective image quality. The second goal is to simplify the subsequent image analysis and recognition, so it is image improvement for machine perception. Third goal is image transformation for technical purposes. For example, when we want to display video on a mobile device, we need usually to change image resolution and aspect ratio without damaging the content of the video. And the last reason is pure entertainment. It's visual effects to get artistic impressions from the effect itself. There are no particular reasons for these effects, but they can be fun, and a lot of cool applications for mobile devices exist that apply visual effects to images. Where are the sources of errors and image defects? Let's look at the image transfer pipeline from real-world objects to its representation on the computer display. First, optical image is formed in the camera. Then it is passed through the Bayer pattern to the sensor array, where it is discretized. Then it is transferred via computer network and displayed on a display. In all stages, image data is transformed. And during each transformation, there can be errors and added artifacts, which we should process. I will give several examples of image defects that can be compensated by image processing. First, images can be of low contrast, with detail difficult to see in bright or dark areas. Second, color tone can look wrong. This picture should be more brownish, and in this light it is more in blue tones, which is unrealistic. Images can be noisy or blurry without sharp details. Lighting in captured documents can be non-uniform, where part of the text is very bright and part of the text is very dark, so it's very difficult to recognize such type of document. Image processing can also be used to extract meaningful information from images. One example I will discuss later is edge detection. Edges contain a lot of interesting information regarding images and can be used as image features for recognition. A lot of algorithms rely on edge detection.